My name is Elizabeth Hillman. I'm a professor of biomedical engineering and radiology at Columbia University and part of the Zuckerman Mind Brain Behavior Institute. My lab at Columbia University develops imaging methods to look at the brain, particularly microscopes, to be able to image the brain really, really quickly. I really love imaging. I've always really loved imaging, and all of my approaches are about trying to just kind of see more and trying to understand more about what we can see in the brain. Long ago, 100 years ago, microscopy started with people looking at very, very thin samples. So you'd have to cut a piece of tissue really, really thinly in order to be able to see exactly what was there in terms of the structure, otherwise a big, big blurry mess. But once you cut something really, really thin, it's dead. And so you can't really see activity and you can't see what's going on. You can't watch how something moves. You can't watch how maybe neurons are flashing with these new fluorescent indicators of activity. So in the meantime, we develop techniques that do so-called optical sectioning, which allows you to use a laser to kind of scan a spot of light around, and that allows you to look at like one single plane within a tissue. And that's completely revolutionized what we can do, because now you can image in an intact brain, you can image in a mouse brain, you can see single cells, but you don't have to cut the brain up. But even still, that technique, and I worked very hard on that technique over my early career, it's very hard to get that to go really, really fast. It's sort of like you're trying to talk to everybody in your family on a holiday, one by one after the other, right? And sometimes you just don't have time to talk to everybody. You just get a tiny amount of time with each person. We wanted to find a way where we could kind of image all of the activity at the same time to get a really good kind of dynamic picture of what was going on without having to look at each location one after the other. SCAPE microscopy is this weird technique that we came up with, me and my students, where we collect data using this kind of sheet of light, and we can sort of create this sheet of light into the tissue instead of just scanning a single point, and then kind of move the sheet of light backwards and forwards to scan a really large area. And that allows us to image the brain at around 10 or 20 volumes a second, with a volume meaning kind of like a whole 3D distribution of neurons. When we first developed it, we didn't really know what it was. We didn't really know what it would be good for, but especially the Brain Initiative has really inspired us to find people who can collaborate with us, who have the kinds of samples that they would really be able to image using this system. And I think it's going to just really allow people to see things that they just couldn't see before. So I get a lot of people coming to me sort of really with an urgency to get this tool, because it's going to let them see something that they've been trying for years to see. I think what drives me is that I really enjoy the success of discovering things. I love to get a new image of a new sample that we've never imaged before. And when you do imaging, you get this really privileged view. You get to see things for the first time, and it can be really scary and really strange. And you show someone and they go, well, the brain doesn't do that. And you say, well, I don't know, I just saw it. So now we have to figure out how to explain that.